Who succeeded Harold as King of England in 1066?
Is there a trick to it?
No, it's just you need to name the person who succeeded Harold as king in 1066.
Well, was it the
don't bastard? Trust him.
The trick is
no,
to
know.
The trick is to know the answer.
I don't trust you at all.
Is it the bastard then?
Who's the bastard? Oh dear.
See?
Oh, it was not a trick.
Did England cease to exist in some way, or was it changed in name?
There was another Saxon claimant who was nominally king for 45 seconds or something.
Well, for a few months, right. Yes, yes. Edgar Aveling. Oh. And he was 15 years old. But Saxon kings were... How did you become a king if you were Saxon?
Did you have to be sort of nominated?
You had to be from one of the five or six families, and then you'd be elected. Yeah.
It's like by what? By votes? They
yes.
They would vote for you?
Yes. Edgar the Aveling. He was 15 years old, but of course William had won the battle, and so he came after him and he tried to fight. He couldn't raise an army, went abroad, you know, didn't really live
well,
a very
15,
successful life.
So he wouldn't have been able to do anything, would he, really?
Edgar the Aveling was proclaimed king by the English after the death of Harold and reigned for 2 months before William was crowned.